In this video, what we're going to do is we're going to create a directory using AI. And so I'm using a tool called Softr here. And what's really cool about Softr is it can create a whole bunch of different applications. It's one of the biggest no-code tools. It really is great for creating these types of directories. So this is really cool because you can create all these different data sources and use these different templates that they have. But what I'm going to do is I'm actually just going to generate it with AI. So what I'm going to do is, these are my options, building a client portal, an internal tool, a directory, or a membership platform. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a directory about different email marketing tools, like Aweber, Canvas, Brevo, and others. That's a prompt for me. And then what I'm going to do is, let's see what this does. So I'm going to put preview your app, and it's going to be creating this for you. Now it's giving this app a name. So Mail Magic, a directory about the different things, and you can choose a different theme. So these are the theme colors you can choose for this. So for this, it doesn't really matter too much, but I do want to go with this modern one, and let's just click generate your app. So this is just an example. You can see on not even 2 minutes into this, and I already have a directory here that's going to be generated. So it's going to go off and do some research for me and do all those really cool things that AI can do. And here we're about 2 minutes in, and it's created this beautiful directory for me. And so you can see here, it's got a cover image, discover the top email marketing tools. It's got a whole bunch of tools. Now, you'll notice I didn't mention MailChimp, HubSpot, SendinBlue, Aweber, Constant Contact. I mentioned a couple of those, but it's built this for me. So this is what it looks like. And if I just click preview here, you'll see what this actually looks like just in 2 minutes, what it's created. So Mail Magic, email marketing tools, it looks pretty good. Of course, you can change this. And here is the directory of email marketing tools. Just taking a little while to load this. So let's go back into the studio. But it's got a search bar here. These are all block-based. So I can add different blocks of different things. Like I could add a form for people to opt in some of these different things. Let's just show this as an example. Okay. Well, I can put in here like a video and then have people opt in, or I can change this form, obviously. I can connect the data source. So I'm just going to delete that block. So this is block-based. So you can add new blocks here and make this app yours so you can copy generated data to your data stores and start using this. If I had this data already, I could use my data. And then let's say I had this in a spreadsheet, I could use my data. But what I can do is I can actually copy the generated data. And let's just add a new data source. Let's just put it in a different account here. So now it's copying the data that is created over to that Google sheet. So it's ready to go. The data looks something like this. And the software makes it display something more like this. Okay. So that's cool. So let's check it out now. And now it's got a spreadsheet I can start continuing from. And it's created all of this data, right? So if I click edit, it will see that here is the data source, and I can edit that data source. So let's go in there right now and take a look at what that looks like. All right, so all I did was log into Google Sheets, and you'll see a copy of Mail Magic and then the app ID here. And this is already in here, so I can start creating all the information if I want to have users here. And on this tab, we have the email marketing tools. So what this is MailChimp. Here is the short description for it and the website. So I could change this. This is a very simple directory. I could change this to my affiliate link. And let's just add another record. Let's say there's one called Zappa email service. And I'm just making that up. And now when we go back here, we're going to refresh this and preview this. And so I just need to preview it again. So right here, you can see that it's got this Zappa email service that I just created, right? And so this is a very simple directory, and we can actually customize these listing pages here as well. And you can customize the pages here. Some of the utility pages would need to be configured. So here's our data source. We can change the custom domain here and put this on a custom domain. I can change the theme. I can change the theme and the font. And what we can do is we can create a listing page template. So I'm going to make a page called listing. Okay. And then on this page, I'm going to use a dynamic blob. Okay. So this is going to be a list item details page. That's what I want. And basically, I need to connect a data source. So I'm going to connect it to the data source that Softr created for me. And this is a copy of Mail Magic, right? So this is the one here. And that's going to ask me which sheet. And what I want to do is I want to connect it to the email tool sheet so that I can put the content in. But now what I have to do is I have to customize these. So heading one is going to be name. So you're going to see an example of that says convert kit. Okay. And this one, which is rich text, we're going to map this to the description, and you'll see an email platform, email marketing platform specifically for creators. Now, if we go back here, ConvertKit, an email marketing platform specifically for creators. So this is pulling it right out of that content. And then tag, we don't have tags. So let's begin add a column here and add in the tags. Okay. Let's do a tag, and the option will be free option or pay only. You can just randomly select a few of these. We'll do pay only. Kit has a free option and Aweber has a free option. So now when we go back here, what we're going to do is we're going to have to connect this tag, but it's not going to see that yet. So what we need to do is preview, everything refreshes and comes back here. Now we'll see, this is a sample record. So this is just choosing a random, one of the random ones that we have there. And we can map this tag. So let's just publish this. So I need to email, verify my email before I can publish it. And we should be able to publish now. Okay, so now that's published, let's do a refresh here. And we still want to configure the content. There's a little circle here that shows it what needs to be covered. So this one isn't mapped yet. Obviously, now we have the tag, right? So we can actually select the tag. And we can add different as well, right? So we can add different items here that can show up. Let's turn on the website because we want to be easy to people to go to the website URL, and we can customize all of this as well, right? So there's different themes for this. You can make this look different with some of these options here, and you can change this. So there's a whole bunch of extra fields. We could have a rich text field, email here. We could have all of these different content pieces. And so let's click publish. Now let's preview it, okay? So right now I'm previewing this. This is a sample record. So you can see MailChimp. It's got the option here for a free option. You've got the link. Now we'll need to change this because these don't make sense. But you can see right here that we've got a pretty functional directory. Looks pretty good on the front end. And we'd be able to add filters. People could tag it from here. And all the layouts can be customized, right? We go back to the main page. Okay, that's actually a listing page as well. So this is our listing page that we've created, but we can actually change the way that this looks if we want. But the main thing is you've got the content here, and we can add a title, a subtitle, subheading. This would be good for SEO. So we can put a dynamic text here that would have your listing in it and different styles. So there's different types of blogs, different types of containers that you can have. which is pretty cool. So you can turn some of that icon off, or just turn off this whole section if you want. And if we go back to our home page here, we can also customize this list here. This is a list block, so we can see the block type here. So we can change it to horizontal cards. Okay, so it can look like this, and we have an image there. So this shows the tags, and so we can change that block type.
All right, so if I do the item details, this doesn't have a lot of different options that I can change this to. And so what you're going to want to do is when you're creating your page, you're going to want to go down here to the item details, and these are all dynamic. And so you can have different layouts for how you want things to be set up. So this is a modern one. You can have the heading here and then the video here, so you can actually have a video. So how we're going to do that is when there's the yellow circle here, this means that something needs to be configured. So we're going to select the sheet. As you remember, the sheet is email marketing tools. Okay. And then you see that the yellow dot is here. So we need to align the content. So we need to map this to the video URL. Now, what I did was I just went to YouTube, got a tutorial for MailChimp, and I created a new column here. And then I just saved it and refreshed. And so now that's actually accessible for me to pick out of my option here. So now I can select a video URL and actually just didn't use, just use the same video for each of these. But you want to pick a specific video for that product, something that really showcases it. So I've got that in, and then I also got to configure the tag. So we've got the tag mapped. So I'll remap that. And the rich text, we're going to go to description. This is just a short description. And then the text should be the description. But the rich text actually should be something more detailed. So what I should do, and I'll just show you this again, you can just add a new column here, insert a column to the left, and I'm going to call this long description. Okay. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to just use AI just to quickly show you. I'm going to go for a new chat here, and I'm going to say, write a detailed description about the pros and cons of MailChimp, include pricing. And I have Claude set on explanatory. You can play around with what option fits best for you. But essentially, this is going to write a description. And this is what you want for the long description, right? And you can go through and do this for all the other options that you have here. And then what I would do if this were not just a test is I would actually go through and clean this up, make sure it's human, and make sure that the word MailChimp and other synonyms like email autoresponder are available and optimized. Obviously, you can put a remove this, but this is pretty detailed. This is extremely detailed. So this is great for SEO content. I'm gonna have a lot of text here that explains about that. So I'm just going to copy this into the long description here. And it's in Markdown. I would obviously change that as well. But as you see here, we can get this configured. So the key is now we go here, rich text, we don't see that, right? So what we need to do here is to preview. Let's just publish these changes. And then I'm just going to click refresh. And when it reloads, what I'm going to be able to do now is under the content, under rich text, I'm going to select where's the long description here. So this just might take a couple minutes to actually connect, but we have published it. So let's just give it another minute, give it another refresh, and then we should be able to find this now. Now we have the long description here. So I just tapped that in, okay? And as you can see here, it's put it all in detail here. Now, I actually prefer connecting with Airtable. For me personally, I would just take the template that they've created with you and upload it to Airtable, because it's a lot easier and friendlier to edit in the actual cell, particularly in the long cell like this in Airtable, than in Google Sheets, in my opinion. But as you can see here, in just a few minutes, now we've got a very detailed description about this. We can publish this. We have the actual listing page. This is what I want. And then we actually had this details page. And this I actually want to get rid of, because this is just a very basic page of the item details. So I wanted to go to the listing. And let's publish that. All right, now I'm going to preview this for you. And you'll see here's the home page. And here's the MailChimp option. When we click on that, we're going to load this page. So this, if I press play, this will play the YouTube video. So you've got that. You've got the tags here. You can have multiple tags. And then we've got a very detailed page about MailChimp. And what you could do is put at the bottom, put a link to the actual listing of MailChimp or your affiliate link. And now you've really got a site. So all you need to do, you don't need to update any pages. You just need to do the same with, let's say, HubSpot. As I said, it uses the same video, but that's just because in the HubSpot record, we need to add the content here. So you just add the content in your Google Sheets, and that's all you need to do. You're good to go. So that's how to create an AI directory using Softr, something that I really recommend that you start and just play around with. If you have some idea, just play around with it. You can publish it on your own domain.
So all in all, this is a really quick way to build a directory. I hope that you've found this helpful and got some other tools about creating directories that you'll definitely want to check out. But this was just an introduction to using Softr. So it's pretty cool. You can preview what it looks like on the different platforms as well really easily. So it's pretty fantastic. Anyhow, I hope this video was helpful, and we'll see you in the next one. By the way, be sure to pick up my directory guide. I have a free guide on some of the best tools to use to create a directory. You'll definitely want to pick that up in the description of this video.